Bill in time to play for $10,000, because at the top of our trivia ladder is a pot of gold of $10,000. Now, congratulations, gentlemen.
Oh, thank you.
It's 3 days to get here,
but
glad to see you here.
Never leaving.
Up until now, you've played as partners. Now you're going to be on your own, each trying to win money for your favorite charity. And, Jamie, which charity are you playing for?
St. Jude Children's Hospital in Memphis, Tennessee.
Good. All right. Wonderful. How about you, Bill?
Salvation Army, just about everywhere.
You bet. Certainly. And Tom?
The Frostig Center for Children with Learning Disabilities.
All right. Three wonderful charities. I want to see you win now. Jamie, you're in the number one position.
Okay.
That means you did best in our trivia race. That means you'll also have the opportunity to play or pass when it comes to our first row of answers. So if you're ready, let's begin our climb right now. Up our ladder toward $10,000. Here's the first level. Jamie, take a look. You'll love these, Jamie.
Yeah.
Camel, motorcycle, airplane, tank.
One of those is my relative.
You want... I didn't know your mother was a tank.
Yeah.
Do you want to play or do you want to pass?
All right, I'll play.
You want to play? All right.
Come on, St. Jude.
Question is yours. You must give me the correct answer. If you do, $1,000, and you'll also earn the right to play for $10,000. Here's the question. T.E. Lawrence, Lawrence of Arabia, was killed in an accident involving which of these? I need the correct answer, Jamie.
Yes, a motorcycle.
You say the answer is a motorcycle.
Yes, it is a motorcycle.
Come on, Jamie.
Thank you.
For $1,000 for St. Jude Hospital is the correct answer, motorcycle.
It is.
Congratulations. You'll be going to the top of the ladder to play for $10,000. Now, Bill, take a look.
Motorcycle.
Let's go to the next rung of our ladder. Here's some answers for you, Bill Cullen, to consider. Swiss, English, Polish, German. Bill, you have the right to play or to pass them on to Tom.
I can do this, but I'll take it. Why stick Tom with it? I'll take it. Whatever it is.
I thought that said Polish. It says
no,
Polish.
No, Polish.
Oh, Polish.
All right. Question is yours. All worth $1,000. You must give me the correct answer, Bill.
Okay.
What is it? Just teasing.
First,
just
I'd
teasing.
Like to eliminate.
Okay, here we go. What was the nationality of William Tell? The man who shot an arrow from his son's head.
He was as Swiss as cheese.
Really? An arrow from his son's head? No, no, Bobby. Shot an apple.
Shot an apple from his son's head with an arrow.
But he was
the other way
Swiss.
Would be much tougher.
Yes.
To shoot an apple into an arrow.
Says here he
tough.
Shot an arrow from his son's head. You're right.
Yeah.
But he was Swiss nonetheless.
Just stand there, Tom, and be quiet for a minute. Will you please?
For
$1,000 for the Salvation Army, is it Swiss?
It certainly is.
Want another pound?
Well, Tom.
While he was riding a motorcycle.
That's true.
Very unusual.
Are you ready?
That's what killed Lawrence of Arabia. Somebody tried to shoot an apple from his head when he was on a motorcycle. Yes, I'm ready.
Oh, let's go to the next rung of our ladder then. Here we go.
Oh,
easy yours,
Dr. Zarkov.
You'll love this. Heartbreak Hotel, Hound Dog, That's All Right, Mama, Blue Suede Shoes. Here's the question. What was the name of Elvis Presley's first record release?
First record release?
That's right.
I guess it's That's All Right, Mama.
You're saying it's That's All Right, Mama?
Well, I mean, the other ones weren't his first.
Okay, for $1,000, chance to play for $10,000. That's All Right, Mama. Let's see. Is it?
Yes!
That one was tough.
Oh, dear. Here we are, guys.
That one was released in Escape.
Who wrote Heartbreak Hotel, you know?
George Hilton.
Close.
Or close. Bob Hilton, your announcer.
Yes.
I'm not going to tell you then. Heck with you. Let's win $10,000
you
for
know?
Your charities. Yeah, I know.
Oh, who? Tell us.
But I forget.
Come on up here and
don't
join
ask
us.
Me.
You've come to the right place.
Who's the heavyset folk singer? Heavyset folk singer.
Burl Ives.
No.
Frank Sinatra.
Who is it? Hoyt Axton. His mother wrote Heartbreak Hotel.
Oh, really?
May Axton, yes. Let's play for $10,000.
Go
right to the top. Here we go, guys. Hang on now. The answers are Twinkies, potato chips, popcorn, peanuts.
Are you selling these, Bob?
Here's the question. According to sales, what is the number one snack food in America? According to sales, what is the number one snack food in America? If you would, please raise the covers in front of you and record your choice.
Oh, we all have to do this.
Yes.
Number one snack food in America.
That's the same question I just asked you.
In America, we We record our answers.
Lock in your answers, please.
Hey, this is fun in here.
I don't have the slightest idea in this world.
I don't.
What are you
either.
Doing, Tom?
I'm fooling around in here.
Oh. Everybody.
I rang and the butler didn't show.
Jamie, what'd you say?
I said Twinkies.
You said Twinkies?
Yeah, that's probably wrong.
I don't know, but it's not. Yeah. What'd you say, Bill?
I said potato chips.
Yeah,
with...
that sounds right.
Really? Tom, what'd you say?
I said rye whiskey. I said peanuts.
You said peanuts?
Peanuts. Good. Peanuts.
All right. Somebody may win $10,000 for their charity. Let's see. Jamie, you said what?
I said Twinkies.
You said Twinkies?
Yeah.
Let's see. For $10,000, is it Twinkies?
I knew that. I got it. I knew that.
No, no, no. And Bill, you said it was
potato chips.
Yeah. Yes.
All right. For the Salvation Army, for $10,000, is it potato chips?
Yes, it is.
GSN makes time for game times of all kinds, from feudal times to reaction times.
This is Ben Rubenstein for Trap, a Mark Goodson Television production.